Today we're playing Mad Scientist with Dilution's White Linen. We're going to mix up a palette of fabulous pastel colors, then I'll show you some fun ways to use them. We all love Dilution's ink sprays, and the versatility afforded us by the white linen is really just another reason to love them. Let's start with the basics and talk about how I mix white linen with other colors. And you'll notice that I have another Dilution's color here, as well as a color wash. And it's been my experience that I can mix any of these things together with white linen to create a unique pastel version of them. Now, what you need to bear in mind is that for every color you want to mix, you either need an empty bottle like this, or you need a bottle of white linen that's almost empty, and that's what this was. I actually mixed color wash butterscotch in here and got this really nice, well, the bottom of the bottle is dirty, but I got this really nice pale buttery yellow that I like a lot. The advantage of working with the Dilution's bottles, or excuse me, with the white linen bottles, is that the mixing bowl is already in there. When you have something like this, which was just an empty bottle that I mixed after midnight with white linen, there is no mixing bowl in here, and so you're left to make certain that you really shake this well to get everything, all that pigment up and moving when you're ready to go ahead and use the spray. Having said that, if you have BBs or some small round metal bits like that, go ahead and put one or two in the jar and they'll act as your mixing bowl. So again, let's go back to talking about it's basically one bottle per color that you want to mix. And I want to shake the white linen first to make certain that the pigment is distributed in the liquid. Oops. And then what I'm going to do is pour some in this empty bottle. And I find that it's better to work with white and then add some color to it a little bit at a time so that you don't end up with something so dark by mistake that you have to keep dumping white in and dumping white in to try to get a decent color. This is Color Wash. This is Wild Plum, and I know that it's a really strong color, so I'm going to start with just a minimal amount, a couple of little drops here, to see how this tints and what it looks like. Give that a good shake, and that's a pretty nice color, but I think I want it a little bit darker than that. And of course, adding is easy. Trying to lighten something that's too dark, not so much. So I'll just do this in stages till I'm satisfied with the final color. And that's getting pretty darn close. I might add just a smidge more to see what this looks like. Again, I'm being cautious not to over-darken it. Okay, and I actually think I like this quite a lot now. What I'm going to do is mix a couple of other colors up. I have lots of empty bottles here, and I'm going to start by putting together some squeezed orange with white linen and then a few other colors, and then I'll come back and we'll talk about some various ways that you can use these mixed colors. There are several different ways to create backgrounds using the white linen mixes that we did just a moment ago, and I'm going to start by using four, and I'm going to shake them off camera so that I know that the pigment's distributed. I have a mix that is the Wild Plum you saw me make. I have Fresh Lime, Calypso Teal, and After Midnight. So I'm going to start kind of at the bottom here, and I'm going to start misting some of, this is the Fresh Lime mix, and I'm going to use all colors that I have mixed with white linen. I want that semi-opaque look on this page, and you can see this really cool blending that happens here. I like that a lot. This is my Wild Plum mix, and now I'm going to come in with the After Midnight mix. Get the top of this page a little bit, and then once I get these colors on here, I'm going to do the same thing that I normally do, which is I'm going to dry this, and then we're going to talk about some other things that I have found that work really well. I've got one section down at the bottom of the page there that didn't have a nice coating of Fresh Lime, but you get this really cool swirling, and of course the white linen makes these colors semi-opaque, and that presents lots of different creative design opportunities, and we'll look at those, but first I need to get this dry. this is all dry now, and so what I'm going to do is I want to show you that even when I mix the colors with white linen, I can still use the ghosting technique. So this is our sunshine stencil, and what I'm going to do is come in and spritz through the opening, and you see that reactivating already when the water hits it, which is really fun. Let me do this one up here, and then maybe do another one a little bit further to the top of this spread. Now, the reaction is a little bit different when it's mixed, when the colors are mixed with white linen, than it is when you use just straight dilutions. So I find that I get better results if I come in and I wipe it up a little bit sooner than I ordinarily would. But you can see that you get, again, this really cool ghosting technique, which provides your page with lots of background texture, and it gives you a head start on layers. One of the things that I really like is this very chalky look that you get with white linen. I think it's quite unique. And you get kind of this blending and running of colors that, because of the semi-opaque nature of the white linen, is very different than when you use just straight dilutions or color wash. I mean, you still get swirly blends, but because this is semi-opaque, the blends are a little bit different. And of course, you can always come in and you can spritz the dilutions mixed, or anything mixed with the white linen, you can spritz directly through a stencil. This is one of the dilution stencils. I think I'm going to put it kind of on an angle. I'm going to shake this up. This is the Calypso Teal mixed with white linen. Again, I'm going to spritz through here, and it's just so cool because it sits right on top and it provides that really cool layer of color. I'm going to add a little bit more over here. And then probably just a smidge along the top here. Now, what I did not do was turn the stencil over and get the negative image, so I can probably, maybe I'll do that up here in this corner a little bit just for some fun. I'm just going to pat this with a paper towel. And how cool is that? All of this wonderful texture, all of this great design is really enhanced with the white linen blends. I think that it's really, really cool to work with. Another way to get some fun mixed up background effects is to start by applying white linen to the page, the entire page, and then spraying regular dilutions or color wash over the top, and then the mixing happens in an entirely different fashion. So I have my bottle of white linen, and what I'm going to do is cover the entire page spread with it, and I'm going to use a pretty healthy coat because I want that mixing to happen. Probably should have put some paper around my edge to protect the overspray, but I've already started, so it's too late now. But that's all right. We'll work around it. All right, so I have a nice, healthy coat of white linen on here now, and what I'm going to do is pick up my colors and get started. I have squeezed orange. Again, I'm getting some really nice mixing and blending of that color. Got some cherry red that I'm going to bring in. And some wild plum, which is going to be a nice deeper color. But again, these colors are mixing with the white and becoming very pastel, as opposed to the stronger colors that I would ordinarily see. And this is, of course, my favorite. It's After Midnight. I just love this color. I think I'm going to put just a smidge in these corners too. Now, all this really cool, interesting stuff is going on. I am getting some significant puddling in the center, and so that doesn't seep through to other page spreads, I am going to pick that up a little bit. Now, I can move this, or I can kind of leave it alone and let the movement happen on its own. But you can see how very different this is than the spread that we did just a second ago. And again, I'm just going to dab this out of here so that we don't get too much bleed through to the other page spreads. It's going to want to move into the center of that page. Now, again, if I want to pick this up, I can really start encouraging this movement. But I think I'm going to leave it alone and kind of let it happen organically. Then I'm going to dry it, and we'll come back and we'll take a look. Again, I'm just going to pick this up. Now, if I wanted to roll this whole thing with paper towel, I could do that. But I really like this patterning, so I think I'm going to leave it alone, let this very organic look continue, and I'm going to dry it. This is dry now, and as you can see, it's an entirely different look than what we did a moment ago. This was the first spread that we did where we used the white linen mixed with colors and sprayed directly to the page, and that was the one in the last segment. And this is what we just did by putting white linen all over the page and then directly spraying the colors into it. Again, it's got this very white, chalky look in places where the color has moved with the white linen and picked that white pigment up and done various things with it as it's kind of blended along the page. Now, the cool thing is that I can still come in with a stencil if I want and pretty much any color. And right now I'm using colors that are not been mixed with white linen. This is more After Midnight. This is one of my diluted versions. And of course, I can spritz this on here. And then I get this really cool effect on top. Because the white linen tends to lighten things and make them more pastel, it's easy to get really strong contrast with the other colors because they're just going to, by their nature, really contrast with the lighter colors on the page. And of course, if I want, I can turn this over. Again, this is Flower Blossoms. I'm going to turn this over, come in with a piece of paper towel, and press this down, and then I can get the negative version of that. And you kind of see this outline of where the flowers are, and even if you really don't see the flower, you get this really cool texture that happens. And as you know, I'm a big proponent of layers and textures in journal pages. I think that they make things really super interesting. Occasionally, I find there's merit in not necessarily cleaning my studio, and sometimes what happens is because I leave stuff out from a previous project or something else I was working on, things present themselves in ways that they might not have ordinarily if I had been tidy. I like my house clean, not so much in the studio, it just doesn't work that way. This is a page spread in my Dilutions Creative Journal, and you can see that there's some bleed through from something that I sprayed on another page spread further on in the book, and it's just because there was so much liquid, it bled back into this. So I'm trying to think of how I can take advantage of this while at the same time minimizing that dark stripe in the center. I had some cut and dry foam left and cut out hanging around here, and I had my freshly mixed colors of white linen and various dilutions. I have black marble mixed with white linen, and I have dirty martini mixed with white linen. I'm picking up on those colors that are already on the page. And what I discovered is that if I put some of this out on the craft sheet, I can pick it up with the cut and dry foam, and I can actually sponge vertical lines and make this sort of funky wallpapery looking background. So let me show you how I do that. I'm going to start with the black marble, and you can see that I've got this color and it's reasonably dark. I'm going to put some out on the craft sheet over here, and I'm going to need a reasonable amount because I'm going to soak some up into the foam, and then I want to make certain I have enough to actually apply to the page. So I'm going to start by picking up some of the color, and you can see I want to be careful to tap some of that extra off so that I don't get sort of this blotch without actually creating stripes, which is what I'm aiming for. And I'm actually just going to run it over the center of this page. And it's doing a fairly good job of covering up that black section that bled through from the other page. And you see that the color is actually fairly controlled when you use this sponge. So now what I'm going to do is grab a different sponge, and I'm going to shake up this mix of white linen and dirty martini. And it's kind of crusted around there from me mixing around so much. I'm going to put some of it out on the craft sheet, and I'm going to do the same thing. And I'm going to end up, whoops, stuck my hand where it shouldn't have gone. I'm going to end up with some really fun kind of grayish and grayish green stripes on here. Again, I'm going to follow through. How cool is that? You can get this really fun striped background, and you can really do a good job kind of controlling your stripes. Now, they're not going to be perfectly straight, and quite frankly, you know me, I'm not big on perfection, sort of the same way I'm not big on cleaning my studio. So I'm going to run this down here. Now, I chose not to dry this before I came in with the next color, so I am going to get a little bit of mixing right there, and I'm not real thrilled with that. So I'm going to pat this. See what it looks like? Yeah, I'm not real thrilled with that either. So, let me hit this with the heat gun and dry it off, and then I can fix this. Alright, that should allow me to do what I need to, which is to just redefine this edge. Yes, that is much better. So I guess the word to the wise here is going to be that you don't want this to be too runny when you come and put the adjacent stripe in, because if it is, you might not be real happy with the results. So I'm going to dry this, and then I'm going to come in and fix this green stripe, and then I'll put the next green stripe in along the way here. All right, that's enough for what I'm trying to accomplish here. Come back and repair this stripe. Oh yeah, much, much better. I like that better. So there's the word to the wise. You really should dry it first. Let me get this next stripe in. And you can see with that gray dry, the green is not blending nearly as much. Give this a quick hit with the heat gun to dry it. Pick up some more on my cut and dry foam. Now obviously the width of the stripes is entirely dependent on the width of the cut and dry foam. So if you cut yours a little bit narrower or wider, you'll get narrower or wider stripes. What I'm going to do is finish this entire pattern across both of the pages in this spread, and then I'll come back and show you something else. So I'm going to finish that up, and then I'll come back. My stripes are all completed and they're dry now, and I'm left with this really funky background. I know that you're not used to seeing me use these colors, but I'm actually pretty enamored with them. They are a little funky and very different from me. I have a green jelly roll pen, and I think what I'm going to do is come in with a pit pen too, and I'm going to follow the lines of these stripes. Again, I'm not trying to be perfect. I'm just trying to put some line on there that creates a little distinction between the two colors. And I like this look, and I think it'll be fun when I get some of the jelly roll pen in here too. And I'm just going to do a little bit of this so you can kind of get some idea of the things that you can do once you get these stripes in place. Now, I already know that there's some limey green glitter that's going to end up on this page, probably punched out in circles with one of those die cuts that you see me use, or the die cutting punches that you see me use. I think that glitter is going to be just fabulous on here. Again, these are very different than the colors I would ordinarily use, but boy, am I liking them. So you get the sense of what I'm doing there. And then what I can do is come in and just come next to it and put a line of, this is metallic green jelly roll pen. And if I don't like the way that that looks, I can do things like this, where I can just kind of make a squiggle line that spans the two stripes of colors. And this is probably a little bit better. It shows a little bit more than what I did a second ago. So I can just come in here and add this here. Again, provide some nice contrast. And of course, you can use this technique where you apply the color with the cut and dry foam. You can do that with the color wash sprays. You just put it out on your nonstick craft sheet, and of course any of the colors of dilutions, and you can create these really fun striped backgrounds. The last thing I want to show you today is yet a slightly different way to use the dilutions, and I'm going to be using the white linen mixed with other colors, but of course you could use them without the white linen mix if you wanted to. I'm going to start by just spraying. This is our Aztec Tiles stencil. All I want is a border of it, and I'm going to do it on both sides of the page spread, but to show you what I'm doing, I don't need to actually work on both sides. So I'm going to slide some paper up here, because there's always overspray when you use any spray with stencil. It's just sort of the nature of the beast, and I really want to not have that overspray hit the rest of the page. So I'm going to hold this in place, and I have three colors of mixed with white linen. I have Dirty Martini, Calypso Teal, or actually this is Fresh Lime. Fresh Lime, Calypso Teal, and After Midnight. And this page background was done with a combination of Fresh Lime, Calypso Teal, and I think I threw some Vibrant Turquoise on there too. Now, because this is not laying flat, I am going to come in here with my fingers as much as possible, which means my fingers are going to get messy, but that's okay. And I want to sort of spray through the opening here so I get a mix of colors. Come in with the Calypso Teal. Oops. Occasionally, these will start to spray funny, as you just saw, and it's a good thing I had this paper down. Because of the pigment in the white linen, it will sometimes clog that sprayer. So there, that's better now. So you have to kind of be aware of that. And then lastly, I'm going to come in with some of the After Midnight. And I'm just going to hit this edge a little bit. And then I want to come down here on this side. All right. Let's see if I can lift this up without making a gigantic mess. Put this to one side. I'm going to need to grab a paper towel to clean my hand. And you see I have the pattern here, which is basically exactly what I wanted. So to make certain that I don't stick my arm in it and then damage the design, I'm going to dry this with a heat gun. And this is not new news. I mean, you've certainly seen me do this before. But what's different, and I'm going to do this time, is I'm going to pick up these mixes with a paintbrush. I've put some hearts on these pages. I just drew them with a pencil, just so I had an idea of kind of how I wanted to lay them out. And I'm going to use the mixed white linen and color dilutions to paint the hearts. And then they can be outlined with jelly roll pens or with just Pitt or Pigma pens, just to sort of make them pop off of the page. I'm going to try real hard not to damage what's already on here, so I am trying to be patient and just get it to dry. Okay, good enough. So I have just a flat brush. Just as I did before, I'm going to put a little bit of this color out on the craft sheet, and I know it's kind of hard for you to see, but it is back here, and that was probably more than what I needed. I want to grab a little bit of the After Midnight, too. And the cool thing is because of the white pigment that's in the white linen, it creates this really chalky, blended look when you apply it with a paintbrush. Sort of like one of those backgrounds we did where you could really kind of see the pigment. So I'm just going to pick this up. Now it's very, very liquid, so I want to bear that in mind. Now I'm going to come in with some of the After Midnight, and I'm just going to brush blend this kind of up the side. And again, you get this really cool, fun, pigmented look. Come in and add a little bit more of the purple. Now that's pretty wet, so I'm going to dry it. And again, you get that chalky look, you get that very serendipitous blending that goes on, which I think is incredibly cool. I'm just going to put this to one side, and I am going to mop this up because I don't want to lean into it when I come in to do the next thing, which is going to be to grab a jelly roll pen or two to outline these. All right, that's pretty good. Now there's not a lot of contrast between this pen and the background, so this might not have been my best choice, but you can kind of see where I'm going. I think I'm going to grab somewhere in here, off camera. Here, I have a purple pen. Let's try this over here. Oh yeah, that's way, way better. And I get this really cool look. I like the effect of that sort of flat, chalky look with the metallic of the metallic jelly roll pen. It's kind of a nice counterpoint, a really cool contrast. And you can do as much or as little of this as you like. I mean, you can sort of sketch out what you want to do here, and you can paint all kinds of really cool things, bearing in mind that your dilutions, whether they're mixed with white linen or not, can work as a paint if you are careful with them, because of course they're really thin-bodied. So dilution's mixology today, we kind of have mixed and matched and made all kinds of really fun messes. And I guess it just goes to show how incredibly versatile these are. And of course, as you work with them, I think you'll find what I did, which is that you can do almost anything with them, including making art and having fun.